actually take the smashes. And they were like not even scared or nervous to play against their seniors. They just gave their best. No pressure, and they did whatever they could.
You look here, the front of play, Mo Jia Chang was superior, and Adrian Chia, who was lacking confidence in the start, bounced back strongly in the end.
Yes, and every time when it comes to that crucial point of 10-all, Adrian Chia was the more confident one to actually execute it. And then Xia Chun Kang also did a good job in his attacking. And looking at the VR here, we can see that they're placing them, running, moving them around the court and then giving a smash, because that's how they create that opportunity. A lot of the times when Aaron Chia and Xia Chun Kang, they are always smashing and sometimes giving the soft touch.
The soft touch proved to be the damage. Chui coming and Lo Jun Cheng were beaten in the front, although they were successful at the back. Although more unforced errors came from the Petaling BC side, it's an upset victory for Petaling BC. Up next is the mixed doubles, the debutant Tanish Virapun and Won Ka Wei up against Chen Tang Jie and David Taker from Matrasat. We'll be right back after this.
Welcome back to the Sports Arena Sentosa. We're looking at the very final tie before the end of this year. It's Petaling BC up against the defending champion PJBC, and we've had a blasting men's doubles action before us. An upset victory to the youngsters from Petaling. Well, up next will be the mixed doubles, and Chen Tang Jie, David Tika from Matasari will be hoping to carry on the fine form of their teammates just now to steer Petaling back into the contention
and
for this tie.
Jaya, Tanish Virapun, and Won Ka Wei.
Won Ka Wei, who made her debut yesterday, will have to guide her partner, who is making his debut today, Tanish Virapun. Won Ka Wei, of course, Malaysian representative in the 2016 Rio Olympics. did lose out to the eventual gold medalist from Japan, Wun Kawei, and her partner Vivian Hu in that Olympics one. But we have to say we were quite impressed with Wun Kawei yesterday, in spite of the fact that they lost out to Terry He and also his partner.
She did speed up her game, but then it was not good enough to go against Terry He. But then, for Tanish, I know him as a state player from Negeri Sembilan, and then he came up to study, and then he continued training in PJ. It'll be a good boost of confidence for him. It'll boost his confidence because playing in the Purple League and partnering Kawei, I hope he will not be pressured, but he will take it as a motivation to play today.
Indeed, he's been one of the players, Tanish Veerappan, who has been training in PJBC's academy, so known as New Vision. This is Wun Kawei, current world ranking in the women's doubles as of late October, 15th in the world, born in Selangor, Malaysia, grew up representing Selangor and Kuala Lumpur. An experienced women's doubles player who, I have to say, also knows her way around the mixed doubles. Former Asian junior champion in the mixed doubles. Wun Kawei. This is Tanish Veerappan, his debut today. World ranking of 495. He spoke to me yesterday and said that he's beginning to focus exclusively on mixed doubles, in spite of being playing singles before. David Tikka Pamatasari. Can we say this is a regular partnership? Current world ranking of 297, born in Bandung, Indonesia. She forms a regular partnership with this man right here, Chen Tangjie, bronze medalist in the last World Junior Championships, world ranking of 93 at the moment, born in Negeri Sembilan, the same place where Tanish comes from. They've played five times in total, Petaling BC's Chen Tangjie and Devi Tikka Pamatasari. They've won three times and lost twice. The twice that they've lost to, it's a really tame defeat to Cheng Chuhan and Ririn Emilia, and also to Lu Qingyao and Chen Xiaohuan, Chinese Taipei. So there's a lot we can talk about the Petaling BC pairing, but what do you think, what can we expect from the PJBC pairing today? Wun Kawei, we know the quality she can produce, and her partner Tanish.
As long as both of them do not make too many mistakes, especially Tanish, because this is his debut, I just believe that they both can actually create an upset against Chen Tangjie and also Devi Tikka, because I feel that Tangjie and Devi are more stronger compared to Petaling Jaya's Kawei and also Tanish.
So we're looking at Petaling BC's matches so far. As you can see there, they've won four, lost one. And their last one will be against Churas BC. As for PJBC, they will be up against Kepong BC in their last tie for phase one of the Samsung Senheng Purple Leagues. It's a tough order for them. Especially as we see Kepong winning today strongly against Bangsa Hawks. But our focus is on this one. Petaling Jaya BC's lead has been cut down to just 3 points now. They're 7-4 in the lead in the overall tie. Here we go. The mixed doubles begin with Wun Kawei on serve. A clever play by Tanish.
Finding the empty spot, Tanish just gave a flick or a push, forehand push to the forehand side of Chen Tangjie.
An easy opportunity.
Mistake from Tanish there, actually, because he gave a half-court shot, but unfortunately Tangjie hit it on the net.
Hammer that one. That's Wun Kawei. Devi Tikka. For both the particularly Chen Tangjie, it has to be said, is a product of this Samsung Senheng Purple League and the vision of Jack Ko, the CEO of Malaysian Purple League. To give young players like him an opportunity, he was not in the national team, made his way to the World Junior Championships semi-finals, and then has been gotten into the national team from there. So, a testament to the results produced by the Purple League.
Carling BC has started attacking more than Tanish and also Koei. A little of miscommunication I saw just now, that since Koei is a left-hander, smashing Tanish should have come behind.
Quick movement forward from Tanish. Wide! It was positive of him to move forward.
He was very confident and he knew the shuttle was coming there. But the last part was the wrong execution from him.
They're struggling to cope at the moment, Tanish.
Speed-wise, Tanjay, and also his partner here, Devi Tika, is faster. And yes, it's true that Tanish is struggling to come back in the front.
Also, there's a lack of sting as of for now from Tanish's smash. He's gonna pack a lot of punch there if he's going to get through to PJ Perry.
Koei's return was a little soft for Tanjay to just flick or jab Tanish there. At the side of Tanish.
It's always a bad idea to lift to a straight area where the female partner is standing. That means the smash will go straight down to the female partner, as they did right there. Won't go away. Well, she knows how to finish in front.
Her height is helping her, and she's controlling faster in the front, which is always Koei. I feel that Tanish has to speed up his game to cope with Koei and also Tanjay.
The service falls, what's that for?
It's always a lot more on their racket going above the hips. Although sometimes we may not be able to see the service judge is there.
Well, but this time Rajasha Amirmazwan indicating that the racket was not pointed in a downward direction upon serve. One-way traffic, Patali in the lead.
Receiving service by Tanish this time was very flat, gave it a bit difficult for Devi to take it.
This mode, defensive shot from Won Kowei.
I also feel that Saling Jaya has been lifting a lot of their shuttles. Instead of playing flat shots, they are lifting and Tanja is just waiting to smash.
Game point opportunities, seven of them in the first game for Patalik. It's Devi Tika on serve. Well, just cleverly closed down that first game. Devi Tika.
The shots were more dominated by Tanjay because he was just so powerful behind there. Kowei and Tanish, I think they should just reduce lifting the shuttles and playing a lot of flat shots instead.
7 minutes is what it took to for the first game to go in favor of Chen Tangjie and David Dekker. If you look at the highlights of that first game, you're absolutely right to point out that Tanish and Kowei were lifting far too much, as we see here.
Yes, and when you're playing mixed doubles or doubles, it's a lot more depending on the flat shots you do, your drive shots, or your push instead of lifting it. And Tanjie and also Davy, they have got so many points from their attacking shots at the rear court, and the mistakes actually were not so many. So it's basically a lot of attacking from Pataling BC that has given them the point in the first game.
We said a creditable performance by both Tanish Veerappan and his partner Woon Kowei. They've not made too many unforced errors, only three from them in that first game. This is a very positive start for Tanish as well, in spite of losing that. So help his confidence as he gets along. Oh, that's wide.
But Kowei should come in the front because she's controlling behind, which should be the other way around.
So it's over 1-0.
Right smile from Tanish.
Fast recovery from Kowei. We can see that she just touched the shuttle and her racket was just up again to get the second shot in.
In the lead now, DJ. She's going to get a bit of a talking to David Dekker, perhaps. Maybe not. That's the right idea from Chen Tangjie. The sports arena, Sentosa, the spectator stands is very nearly full here. It's a great turnout today, and the crowd are really enjoying the badminton that they're seeing here. Good lead, Pataling Jaya. 5-1, it's a miscommunication in the Pataling camp.
And for Kowei and Tanish, they're slowly getting the rhythm of it. We only saw them lifting up once instead of compared to this first game.
Nothing wrong with that serve, indicates the service judge. This is a very good showing by Tanish. And that lift there got them into trouble from Tanish.
The recovery from Tanish, she was smashing at one corner and then just moving for the second one. By right, it could have been a side-to-side smash. It was slow from Tanish to move.
That's
point, 8-3.
A lot more of attacking shots from Tanish and Kowei in the second game.
It's out as well, 9-3. Of course, you do need to realize that Chen Tangjie and Davy Tika Pumatasari are playing with the drift behind them, meaning that the shots that they play flat are much more likely to sail long at the back, being gently guided by the wind. 10-3, it now seems to be an unassailable lead for PJ.
Kowei still has the touch in the front.
Shot from Tanish to finish that off.
From a singles player coming to a mixed doubles player, he has that flexibility, only that this time he was smashing and being more aggressive on the court.
Well, if I said there was no sting in his match, I'm absolutely wrong. The sting has just come back. 11-3 in 5 minutes for Tanish and Kowei. Here we go, looking at the highlights of that second game. Once again, just building upon the point that Tanish, sting in the attack, is back.
And he's not, he didn't look so nervous than how he played enough, because probably it was his first game, a debut, then he was feeling it. But this time, I think Kowei was there also to motivate him.
It was a great height for badminton, Tanish. A great temperament on court as well. But so has Chen Tangjie and David Tika. Interesting to see whether these two can bounce back, or whether the debutant will steal the show.
Third game, level play.
As the third game gets underway.
Service for call.
This time it's service not struck above the waist.
Yes, Kowei is asking, and then service judge is saying that her racket was above the hips.
Well, looking at that, I have to agree with the service judge's call. It's a great call from Raja Shah. Oh!
Confident receiving service from Tanish. Sometimes it's not. You don't want to stand too much in the front because you don't feel that confident. Tanish was good in that.
Buried that shuttle with fury.
So it's over. Chen Tangjie.
3-1. Amazing scrambling defense from Tanish, and in the end, Chen Tangjie puts the shuttle to rest.
You see the coach telling Tanish not to lift the shuttle, could have just pushed it instead.
This has been a great rally from both players. I think there's some significant improvement. Tanish Virupan in particular is been absolutely impressive. He's growing throughout this match. And I'm just wondering, Stephanie, whether you think that perhaps that Chen Tangjie is feeling a little bit intimidated because he's playing against his senior, formerly in the state BA. He probably has played Tanish before in the training state training center and lost to him many times, being the junior. Now playing him again, whether he's still affected, the fact that he's playing his senior.
For me, I wouldn't agree to that, because Tangjie has been the more progress. He's been doing really well at international level, and Tanish has not been going so far yet. But I feel the communication between Tang Jie and also Devi Tika is probably lesser compared to Tanish and Kowei.
Indeed, you're absolutely right. Kowei has been whispering a lot of things into the ears of Tanish. 5-2 now. Devi Tika on serve. From Devi Tika. That flat smash from Tanish did the damage.
And quite a number of times they're attacking Devi Tika, they're not even attacking Tang Jie, which is a good strategy.
Sometimes when you're attacking, you want to get the racket, your opponent's racket away in defense from their standard position, and the flat smash sometimes gets the racket up, leaves the center open again for the attack. Exactly what Tanish did the last time round. It's 5-3 now. TJ still behind. Was both players missing it.
Yes, the first one, Tanish was able to take that powerful smash from Tang Jie, and the second one, even he couldn't believe that he was not able to return it.
I felt it was a miss hit from Chin Tang Jie, to be honest.
And also a miss hit from Tanish.
Six three. The Taling have the lead.
Resting from Kowei at the front court. Sometimes you have to be so careful in the front because you want to be too. When you're too careful, that's when you make the mistakes. Has made quite a number of mistakes there when it comes to that half-court shot. He is always lifting it half-court where it's easy for Tang Jie to smash it.
Well, just wisely played cross-court from Devi Tika.
Tanish's shots are not flat enough to the side of the court.
Well, this is absolutely brilliant defense from Tanish. Okay, the shuttle down so sharp, almost vertically, Chin Tang Jie. Game point, seven of them for the Taling BCs. Devi Tika, who's on serve. Taking the first time round, it's 11-4. The third game, won by the Taling BC.
Communication there. Kowei was definitely expecting Tanish to take because it's Tanish's forehand. Because for Kowei, if she were to do that smash, it's going to be a backhand shot for her.
Confirmation of the score, 11-4 in 5 minutes. Once again, Chin Tang Jie, Devi Tika for Matasari coming away the winner. Now looking at the third game highlights, so a good performance from Tanish, but I just felt that Chin Tang Jie has just come alive suddenly.
Also felt that Tanish's smashes are still not as powerful as Tang Jie. His smashes have been just nice, but not all the time doing well. And also his defense. The first shot he's able to take, the second or the third one is a little loose on him. For Tang Jie and Devi, they have been probably the most of it was just attacking on the left, right-hand side of the court, and also a lot of baseline shots.
Five of those shots went to the left-hand side of Tanish Veerappan and Woon Kowei. And of course, it's the more experienced player, Woon Kowei, has got to motivate her partner to get things going, rolling from PJ's side. first point to Tanish. Aggression from him in this game.
Because instead of pushing the shuttle behind, she just gave a slow touch at the empty spot there. Both of them were there, but not to the corner side.
It's all about being able to sustain the lead. Tanish and Wunker Ways raised to a 2-0 lead now. It's up to Petaling to catch them. Devi Tika on serve. Been impressed by a lot of things from Tanish today. His smashes have improved in the second game, and now his return of serve. A couple of times now he's caught his opponents.
The only thing lacking from Tanish is that whenever he pushes the shuttle, it's not good enough. It's not going baseline, or it's not flat enough.
So look at the clock on the top left corner of your screen, you'll realize that it's come down to 11 minutes. We do have a 30-minute ruling system in the Samsung Genting Purple League where the match has to be completed in 30 minutes. Or else the pairing for the player with the most points in that game will take that game. Inching ahead, PJ. What a smash from Devi Tika.
It's not that often you see Devi Tika smashing. A really powerful one, and it was so at the corner there where Tanish couldn't even reach to get it.
Level 4-0. Call wide by the line judge. Great call by Tanish to his partner.
5-4. So that's the reason why he couldn't make get the shuttle flat.
This has not been the usual Chen Tangjie we have seen. He's been playing some excellent badminton, but this is certainly not one of them. It's 5-all, he's on serve. Tanish has been surprisingly moving too much to the front, and this time still winning it in spite of that.
I only feel that it's not consistent. Sometimes he's doing really well, and at times it's just a simple mistake.
He's kept PJ in the lead still in this fourth game.
Fast one from Devi Tika. She intercepted the shuttle very fast in the front. And that's a girl, that's how she should be helping the band behind.
Can't can Pataling go into the lead? Well left by Chintang there, he was intending to take that at first.
Wide out from Tanish.
He clutches his head. Oh, he knew that was coming. Good reading, Tanish. Frustrated looking Chintang Jie. Missed the golden opportunity in front. Devitika.
A lucky shot for Kowei because her net shot was really high.
Once again, she misses it in front. Unforced errors. 10 to 12. More of them coming from the Pataling side. That's wide!
The idea was there from Tanish. Fortunately, it went out. He's looking out for that empty spot there, but just a little bit wide out.
He screams in anguish. This is a chess game we are seeing in front of us. Once again, Wun Kowei moved to the back and being kept at the back.
At the moment now that Tanish and Kowei will not be affected of the line call.
But surely they have to be. It's absolutely frustrated, Tanish. Does seem as if he has a case. Chintang Jie on serve. Match point. And they do it! Come through in the midst of controversy to win it.
Even the last service was also a controversial one there, I would say, but the service judge did not fault Tang Jie. It was a little speechless for me at the last 2 points of the score.
Indeed it was. Speechless moments for us. Chintang Jie prevails with his partner Devitika 11-4, 3-11, 11-4, 11-9. And we've come close to the 30-minute mark here.
The last game actually saw both of them. It was a balance where one of them were getting points and then there was mistakes and then points again. But towards the end, it was Devitika that made a few unforced errors in the front court. I felt it, the game would have gone to Kowei and also Tanish if it was not for the last two calls.
Yeah, it could have been argued. As we look at this here, you see that the constant pressure of Chen Tangjie and David Tika in that fourth game managed to do the trick in the end.
Yes, and they were always trying to bring Kowei behind instead of Tanish. A disappointing one for Kowei. And looking at the VR here, Chen Tangjie is actually moving Kowei behind, like I said just now, which is supposed to be Tanish at the behind court. There's a miscommunication there because Kowei is a left-hander. And then now David Tika giving to the forehand. And then next it will be another backhand shot again. This is where the miscommunication happened for Tanish and also Kowei.
They did say close but important victory for Petaling BC. You can see that they've made one more unforced error than their opponents. Dominated the rear court 15-7 and also the front court went to Tanish and Woon Kowei, who was dominant in front. That has been the mixed doubles. Up next will be the final men's singles. Lee Chukyu up against Iskandar Zainuddin. We'll take a short break. More Purple League action continues after this. Well, the matches today have been looking pretty much one-sided, all four matches. It's in Chen Tangjie and David Tika Bumatasari that's dominated the last mixed doubles one. Up next is the men's singles, Lee Chukyu taking on Iskandar Zulkarnain Zainuddin. Players are just seconds away from making their way on court. We'll let the MC introduce the first players on court. Played in every single appearance for Petaling BC, Iskandar won four of them. The only loss he's had so far was to Leong Junhao. Also, Lee Chukyu has played in every single appearance for Petaling Jaya BC unlike Iskander, he's lost twice, winning three times. The two defeats of Lee Chukyu came against Wei Nan and Tommy Sugiyato yesterday. Both of those defeats were 3-0, 3-0 defeats for him. But as for Iskander, he has beaten Wei Nan 3-1 in this season. So on paper, perhaps form favoring Iskander. We'll wait for the coin toss before we get into that.
Receive.
Yep, speaking about the forms of floor, Stephanie, Iskander is on a fiery form at the moment coming into this.
I would say it's going to be an interesting game because Chukyu is more of an attacking player and Iskander is one person who just likes to take all the shots and make it until your opponent makes the mistake. So this is how Iskander's style is, and from those days that's how he used to play. So it's going to be an interesting game between a rally game or an attacking game.
Looking at Lee Chukyu, current world ranking is of late October, 41 in the world, born in Kowloon, Hong Kong. He has, of course, as we mentioned, 3 wins so far in this season. His opponent for today, Iskander Zulkarnain Zainuddin, has dropped in the world rankings, is currently 99 as of late October, born in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. At one point of time, Malaysia's number 2 in the men's singles, behind Dato' Lee Chong Wei. Of course, he's had a drop in form, it has to be said. Iskander, due to an injury he sustained, he's on the path to complete recovery. Looking at Rajashah Amirmazwan, the umpire, and Stephen Ong, the service judge.
Ready to play?
Would you favor Lee Chukyu for this one?
I'll go with Iskander because he's always been the one who's consistent. He may not be an attacking player, but he's very consistent. I'm hoping to see that today.
Yeah, I have a feeling it's going to be Iskander as well. Judging from the form he's had, it's been an remarkable form. He's defeated Zulfadli Zulkifli 3-0. He's defeated Wei Nan 3-0. Has defeated Panawit Pongnam 3-1. It's been a fine form for him so far in this season. And when I did speak to him, Iskander always looks tentative, always looks like wants to give his opponents a little bit more respect sometimes than they need. Lee Chukyu has to make amends for his team yesterday. There's only 1 point separating both these clubs. Patali Jaya ahead by 1 point, 8-7.
Represented by Lee Chukyu. And on my left, Patali BC, represented by Iskander Zulkarnain Zainuddin. Patali Jaya BC, love of play.
Here we go then, the final men singles. It's long at the back.
1-2.
Let's land it in.
Both players are just wanting to open the game now, since this is their first 2-3 points.
This is from the Sultan Maksiata Malaysian International, Iskander. Fine form as you see him here.
That is it, the attacking shot that I said, which was strong on Lee Chukyu. But Iskander, the first shot he actually lifted instead of doing a block.
from Iskandar.
That's how Iskandar always plays. He's always just taking all the shuttles and then one fine good shot hit it and he goes in really fast for the follow-up.
That's long. Quite some margin.
It's over 3-all.
Gonna be called good.
4-3.
Unforced error by Chip.
Down the shots here. Sends sprawling this time, the Malaysian.
The deceptive drop by Chung Yu there. He's just twisted or moved his racket face a little bit there to trick Iskandar to the front court.
In a slim lead at the moment. It's too powerful for Iskandar to handle.
Thanks to Chuk Yu's flick service there, Iskandar was not even expecting that shot to go behind.
It's hit him in the back. A funny shot, he's left it, but it's fallen on him as we see here.
He didn't move too much in the front.
Well, the power play is certainly with Li Chukyu. Hanging in, Iskandar.
Powerful smash from Iskandar. We had to see Iskandar doing those kind of smashes, but if he gets the chance, only then he will do it. He's not an attacking player, as I said before.
Back level 7-all, everything to play for. Hospitaling just 1 point behind PJ in the overall score, 8-7. Just slipping ahead. Li Chukyu. Just too confident in the attack, Li Chukyu. Iskander is doing to contain Lee Chok Yew.
Attacking at the same spot, thinking that will be a place to trick Iskander, but he was just, Iskander was just ready to return it back. You could see that his raker face was actually twisting a little bit when he did that tap.
So just brushing across the feathers, Lee Chok Yew, that compromised the speed of it. 8-9.
Get it across, cut slice there.
Well, this Iskander has come from the back twice now to level up things.
There was this kind of mistake because Chok Yew was not even doing a double shot. He moved faster actually.
Misreading it. The most crucial of moments. Game point opportunity. Can Chok Yew convert? Will Iskander find his way back? Indeed he does. Steno once again. A treat to a double game point situation.
Quite a number of times today we've seen this double game point.
We saw this in the women's singles, we saw this in the men's singles. And yes, Tana Zuccaro has come back to win the first game in 11-10.
That was a mistake by Chok Yew because when he pushed the shuttle, it was not even baseline. Iskander took that opportunity to just attack him at the body.
Confirmation of the score, 11-10 in 10 minutes of play. The first game to Iskander.
After rally, relax, punctual. Play focus, punctual. Okay, no punctual and play. When you receive service, ready. Service ready. After play, okay, relax, no problem. Okay, this is very important.
Looking net, your feeling, right? Okay, go on.
Also, what an animated style of coaching, Yogendran. To his charge, Lee Chok Yew. Be ready at serve, and after that you can relax.
And yes, Iskander has won many of the points at the baseline shots. I think he's been doing a lot of attacking at the baseline for Chok Yew to. It's very difficult for Chok Yew because he's moving a little slow in the first game.
But you're looking at some of these spectators here in the sports arena in Sentosa. I told you, the stadium almost filled to the brim on the spectator stands. Continuing that great run, Iskander.
It's 2 to 3 times that Iskander has been smashing to the body of Chok Yew, probably the weakness where Chok Yew is having now.
Yeah, he tends to move too quickly, Chok Yew, and sometimes that goes against him. Unable to get it this time. The run of three straight points from Iskander comes to an end. That's called good.
One.